I'm Callum, and in this video we'll be looking at pointers. Hopefully, you've already seen Emily's video explaining an overview of pointers and dynamic memory. In this video, we'll be looking at how to deal with pointers in code. So let's get started. Let's start off with an easy example. I'm going to make a file called pointers.c. And in this file, we just want to start out by printing a number. So let's create a variable, int a, and make that equal to, well, let's call it my number. Let's make that equal to 42. All right, we want to print out that number. But first, let's think about what is my number. My number is a container, and that container has the label my number. And the kinds of things it holds are ints. The value inside the container called my number is 42. All right, so we want to print out the int stored in my number. So we'll do that with a %d, and then we put the variable my number right there. All right. Now, let's print out some more information. My number is a variable, and that means it exists somewhere in memory. Now, if it exists somewhere in memory, that means it has a memory address, and we can print out that address. So let's try that. We want to print out the address of my number. Which is on the stack. And the stack is just part of memory where variables will normally go. All right, so let's print that out. We can use %p. Now this is a new one. We use this for addresses, to print out addresses, and to print out the contents of pointers, which we'll get to in a bit. All right, so let's print out the address of my number. So here, the ampersand can be read as the address of. So if you see the ampersand in front of a variable, you can read it as the address of that variable. In this case, the address of my number. All right, let's see what that looks like. Let's compile that. I'll copy that up to the CSC servers, and then SSH in, and then compile that with DCC. All right, and then we'll run it with a.out.a.out, and we get 42, as expected. And we also get this number here, 0xffdbf5d0. Now the 0x denotes that the following number is in hexadecimal format. And hexadecimal format is a number format where there are 16 digits. It goes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 9, and then it goes A, B, C, D, E, F. That makes 16 if you count it up. All right, so that's good so far. Let's take this a step further. What if we want to store the address of my number? We want to store this number in a container. How are we going to do that? Well, we can do something like this. Int star pointer to my number. So that's the name of the container. That's the name of the variable. Ampersand my number. Now let's have a look at what's going on here. We have this int star, right? Int star. Now, when you see this, I want you to think about this as if there were imaginary brackets around the int and the star, right? Like this. Because this here is one thing. It means the type of the container, the type that the container holds, is an int pointer. not an int, an int pointer, right? The asterisk is not attached to pointer to my number. It's not attached to the variable. It's part of the type. So what are pointers? Well, pointers are just containers that hold addresses. So we are putting the address of my number, this number here, we're putting that into the container pointer to my number. All right. Let me write that in a comment above. So we're storing the address of my number in a variable. And the type is pointer to my pointer to an int. All right, now we want to print that out as well. So let's see how we can do that. Again, we'll use %p because we're printing out an address. %p, and then we're going to put pointer to my number. And notice that we don't need an ampersand before this variable. That's because this variable holds an address. All right, so let's try that now. I'll copy that back up again. And then I will compile it with DCC. And then run a.out. And there we go. We get 42, and then we get the address where 42 is stored. And then we get the address again, printed out from the variable pointed to my number. All right, there's one last thing I want to show you in this video. And there is a special kind of pointer called null. And this pointer points to a special part of memory. It points to the bottom of memory, and it's taken to be a special meaning. Null means not an address. There will never be anything stored at null. So let's print out null to see exactly what it is. Let's print out as an address, so we use %p, and we'll put here null. And let's see what that prints out. Alright, it prints out nil. So the actual value of null is 0, or 0x00000000. Now, if you try this, and I encourage you to try this, try writing this program, running it yourself to see, you know, answer any questions you might have, right? You might notice that your computer has a different number of digits here in the hexadecimal number. Now that's dependent on whether you're on a 32-bit system or a 64-bit system. The number needs to be large enough to describe any address in your RAM. So if you have a computer that has much more RAM, it will need a bigger number. All right, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.